viewers at home, where can you go from his presence? Thank you. You have on your table, are you a friend of God? I know everyone will say yes. Thank you. That is on your table. Take it run. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yes. I know you saw some message rolling on the Monday TV since yesterday. Well, God's time is the best. I want to believe this is God's time. Are you believe that?
Yes.
This is God's time. Hallelujah. Yes. We have minus some minutes, let me say 40 minutes out of our time. So we mean we are going to manage the little time God has given us to deliver this message. Hallelujah. Yes, last week we talked about entrance to prayer. And today we We continue where we stopped last week. And for the benefit of those who are not actually be taught in the spirit, well, I think we have to take the message back. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I will take the message back. Let's look at the book of James. The book of James, James 1, I'll take my reading, and our proof text will be taken to verse 22, but let me take it from verse 1. When you get home, take your time to read your book. James, a budding servant of God, and of the Lord Jesus Christ. I'm taking from James 1, verse 1. I take once again. James, a budding servant of God and of the Lord Jesus Christ, to the 12 tribes which are scattered abroad, greetings. Verse 2. My brethren, count it all joy when you fall into various trials. What could be the trials? This here is described as various trials. That's several trials, many trials. Verse 3. Knowing that the testing of your faith produces patience. But that's verse 3 once again. I take it once again. Knowing that the testing of your faith produces patience. Verse 4. But let patience have its perfect work. Have its work, its perfect work, that you may be perfect and the word complete, lacking nothing. I take verse 5 this time. We can now go to our proof test. If any one of you lack wisdom, let him ask of God. Take note of that. I take it once again, verse 5. If any one of you lacks wisdom, let him ask of God, who gives to all liberally. Take note of the word liberally. And without reproach. And without what? Reproach. Take note. And it will be given to him. Let me go to verse 22. But be doers of the word, and not hearer only, deceiving yourself. So I want to take it here. Before we now go back to our book last week, which is Psalm 66, verse 18, that will definitely take us there. So, and I will take the message title, The Futility of Self-Effort. The Futility of Self-Work. The Futility of Self-Effort. Hi. Are you there? I'm here. As for them, are you there? Give me your heart. I can't hear you. I can't hear you. I can't hear you. Give me your heart. Hallelujah. The futility of self-effort. Let me take you back to that book of Psalm 66, verse 18. Remember, we are coming from the book of James back to Psalm, New Testament to Old Testament. If I regard sin, iniquities in my heart, the law will not hear me. That is verse 18. If I regard iniquities, that is sin, in my heart, the law will not hear me. Take note of the word in my heart. Take note of the word in my heart. In my heart. In my He said, if I regard iniquity in my heart, the law will not hear me. Take note the word in my heart. Going by the sons, we are made in our heart to be like Jesus. Going by the Son, we are made in our heart to be like Jesus. On the last day, we will be judged not by the color of our skin, but by the content of our character. We will be judged not by color of our skin. But by the content of our character. On the last day, on the last day, only through the our skin, but by the content of our character. True Christianity lies in the heart. Tell your neighbor, give me your heart. I can hear you. I can hear you. I can hear you. I can hear you. True Christianity lies in the heart, in the purity of heart. In the purity of heart. In that verse 22, that book of James 1, take it back to that verse 22, book of James. But be doer of the word and not hearer only, deceiving yourself. Many Bible students, many church people, many Christians are deceiving themselves because they are not acting, living, and doing the word. Many of us, we Christians, Bible students, are deceiving ourselves because we are not acting, living, doing the word. now look at the book of Colossians 3 verse 10. The mind is renewed by studying the word and by acting upon it. One may read or study the Bible for years. If he or she does not act it, live it, he is not a doer. The mind is not renewed. In that 3:10 Colossians, the mind is renewed by studying the word and by acting upon it. One may read, may study the word for years. If he or she does not act it, live it, is not a doer. The mind is not renewed. Christ and the Word are one. Christ and what? Are one. Meditation in the Word is a visit to Him. The Word becomes a part of us by meditation. Tell your neighbor, the Word becomes a part of you by meditation. I can hear you. I can hear you. The word become a part of you by meditation. Meditation in the word is a visit to Him, to God. If you want to visit Him, meditate in the word. You want to visit Jesus, you want to eat with Him, you want to sleep the same bed, the same room with Him, meditate in the Word. Meditation in the Word is a visit to Him. Tell your neighbor. I can hear you. I can hear you. I can hear you. It's a visit to Him. It is the Word dwelling in us, which is equivalent to Christ being in you, personal being you. It is the Word dwelling in you, which is equivalent to Christ personal being in you, Himself living in you. The word dominating you is the lordship of Christ in you. Dominating you is the lordship of Christ in you. You want to visit Him, meditate in His word. Today, many church people, many of us, pray within and pray without. Let me put it that way. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Within doubt. Pray without, within doubt. Is praying in the name of Jesus, 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 in the name of Jesus. Within doubt, we must live to God, not only clean hands, but a pure heart. What is it? In my heart, not only this hand, your heart also must be pure. We must live up to God, not only clean hand, but a pure heart. Claim to stop our bad habit without, but within the urge continue. We claim to stop our bad habit without, within urge to do them, continue. Urge to do them, continue. Within, urge to do them, continue. When you stop your bad habit with self-effort, you know that are self effort and God's effort. God's effort is grace. When you stop your bad habit with self-effort, the urge to do them will continue. Because self-effort cannot stop the urge. But God's efforts only can. Many become Christian, born again, pastor, bishop, prophet, with self-effort. Self-effort leaves us with urge. Self-effort leave us with what? With urge. That which come out of the heart defy the man. That which come out of the heart defies the man. Self-effort, a wrong attitude towards sin. Without Holy Spirit destroying the root of sin in us, we are bound to be tormented from desire to return to our bad habits. Without Holy Spirit destroying the root of sin in us, we are bound to be tormented from desire to return to our bad habits. Challenges many Christian believers, pastor, and so on and so forth are facing is the problem of urge behind closed door. Called to do this, us to do that. How to do this? They will not do it. They will not do that. Us to push this, us to push it. They will not push this thing, but there's hard to push it. And if there's hard to push this thing and you are not pushing it, it's like you are in bondage. Us to slap, come sir, come here. I have hard to slap you, but I cannot because I'm a Christian. That hurt will put me in bondage. Because those who are inwardly pure show themselves to be under the power of pure. Sit down. Tell your neighbor, those who are inwardly pure shows themselves to be under the power of pure. Those who are inwardly pure show themselves to be under the power of pure. If I have urge to slap you, but because people know me as a pastor, if I slap you, that is the end. You will not believe me anymore. Because I want to keep my name in the eyes of people, not in the eyes of God. But the hurt to slap you is there, but people are looking at me. People know me as pastor. If I slap you, that is the end of my career. I will resist that. But that urge is there. I'm in bondage. God cannot hear me. Without Holy Spirit destroying the root of sin in us, we are bound to be tormented from desire to return to our bad habits. After stopping your bad habits by self effort ought to do them. Continue. Self-effort cannot stop the hodge, but God effort, grace, only can. Why this is where the word contentment comes. I'm a pastor. No matter what I'm doing here, if there's urge in me, the urge to do more, look at what do I need again, I will say, let me carry the money I have to do, to buy a car, to become car dealer. Let him join politics. Let him do this. Let him do that. Because there is hodge. But instead of me to think of how to expand the kingdom, the coast of this kingdom of God, save more soul, more deliver more people, which is very possible, the urge for this, urge for that, urge for this, urge for that. I'm a president today. Yes, who is my wife here? It's not fit at all. I need professor as a wife to follow me anywhere I'm going. Many first lady are not first wife. Look at you, you have many business cards in your pocket. You are the architect, you are the contractor, you are the lawyer, you are the doctor, you are a pastor at the same time. It's all caused by urge. Urge give us, you can never be content when you have urge. You continue to chase it and run it and all and all and all. You continue and continue and continue. Look at your pocket. You have many. That is the problem. 99% of the whole world are having today. You check your pocket, you see many business cards. If they call contractor, you bring it out. If they call this, you bring it out. We have people that have 500 houses. Only Lagos stayed here. But they don't even know the number of houses they have. It's all caused by urge to do more. Urge. Look at you. You are here today. You look around the appearance of food. Ladies, women, we want to look at a style, air style. Oh, I like this style of air. Look at the way they plane it. By the time you leave here today, tomorrow you begin to look for salon, hairdresser that will paint your hair in the same way. You now draw the picture. This is the way I want my hair to be. Every day you keep changing the style of your hair. Urge. Are you talking of your color? You are once black, yellow, red, green, pink, and so on. You keep changing the color of your hair until the skin is destroyed. Urge. Urge. Look at your garage. You don't mind to loan money to buy a car because you like a certain car, a certain Porsche Jeep. Oh, this is latest. Are you talking of your iPad? The manufacturer know that when they release new iPad today, you drop the one you have. You keep running after it. They keep promoting the new latest answered iPad. You keep dropping it. If you don't have money, you get money at all costs to get iPad, to get latest technology. Where are we going? Self-efforts, we only commit God's word to memory, which is valuable, no doubt about that. But God's efforts, grace, letting the word become an integral part of them. Integral part in them. Self-effort cannot bring Jesus to the scene. In the name of Jesus, be healed. Jesus cannot come to the scene with self-effort to be born again. Self-effort in born again, self-effort in become pastor, self-effort to become bishop or prophet, self-effort to become a Christian. Look, because the hodge is there. In the name of Jesus, be healed. The hodge is there. And this hodge in you, torment you, is saying different things, and you are confessing different things. Hodge is telling you, Hodge is telling you to slap a man, but because you are a Christian, you say, "Why should I slap a man?" You can resist it. So you are confessing different things, but Hodge is saying different things. But God's effort, grace, brings Jesus to the scene. Be healed in the name of Jesus. Be delivered in the name of Jesus. Be saved in the name of Jesus. Yes, the believing heart is released by faith. And you know, faith is of man's heart. It's not man's flesh, not man's body. Faith is of man's hearts. The belief in our heart is released by faith out of our mouth. Happiness of seeing Jesus is promised to those and those only who are pure in heart. Tell your neighbor, the happiness of seeing Jesus. The happiness of seeing Jesus is promised to those and those only who are pure in heart. Happiness of carrying out God's commission is promised to those and those only who are pure in heart. To carry out God's commission, you know, the Bible says, go into the world and preach the gospel. Just say, okay, let him go and preach the gospel. Whereas, truly, inwardly, you are not there. Say, Jesus is Lord. I'm telling you, accept Jesus as your Lord and Savior. In this process, many have been delivered through that. Many have been delivered. You know, you are in that business in the past. You go out sending pamphlets, preaching the gospel. Oh, you know, Jesus is Lord. You know, you are to accept Jesus as your Lord and Savior. Yes, whereas inwardly, you are not pure. And the Bible says, the happiness of carrying out God's commission is promised to those and those only who are pure in heart. Be delivered, be saved in the name of Jesus. If you say, be healed, and you are healed, you should know that inwardly something is there. It's not what you say that really matter, but the source. That what you say coming from. Okay, you are seeing river. Look at it. Let me give you a good example. There is a river, big river, very dirty one, so dirty. People will go there and use themselves and urinating and all sort of things. Even human body can be dropped inside that river. But by the time the river is going, it's fine way through the path, bush, you will see it becoming clean as long the more longer the river goes, the more it clean. The people, the wind, the many things will try to separate those things, make it clean. Okay, by the time the river, okay, this is sea, and this is in Nigeria. By the time this sea find a path to go to Togo. On getting to Togo, it will become clean. But here in Nigeria, it's a dirty water. So by the time the people, neighboring countries see it very clean, they begin to drink it. But if they know the source of that stream, they will not want to drink it. But because they don't know the source of that river, the stream, they have to drink it because it's pure. But if they show you about this water you are drinking in your community, this is the river that bring this water, and you see dead body, that shit and all of that. No matter how clean the water is, you say, over my dead body. You will forget about the cleanliness, the appearance of the, because that's, so what I'm saying is that if I say to you, be healed in Jesus' name, Don't mind what I say, because Satan too can say be healed in Jesus' name. He can mention be healed. Satan can say in Jesus' name. Nothing will happen to him. You don't need license to say be healed. You don't even need any license to say be healed. Be healed in Jesus' name. That word be healed in Jesus' name. Anybody can say it. What you should bother about, the source of that be healed in Jesus' name. That is C. To know the source, take you back again. True Christianity lies in the heart. So I want to leave you. I believe your faith is lifted up. Let me see your hand. Viewers at home, I know many of your questions have been answered. Finally, after stopping your bad habit, by self efforts, I will not drink again. You feel hot. No. I will not go there again. You keep yourself. Self effort. The urge to do them continue, because self effort cannot stop the urge. Anybody can pray in the name of Jesus. Like I have said, we pray without, within doubt. So, thank you, Jesus. I'll take you from here. Hallelujah. Rise up, rise up, rise up.